Well, welcome to Blitz 8. Thanks for watching us this year. It's maybe one of our best Blitz 8 years ever, and we're glad that you've been watching. We're hoping you're bringing our playoff game tonight. Is the playoffs starting? BCD and 8-man. Let's start in Class B. Two-time defending champion Marshwood hosting Gorham. Opening Hawks possession, Cam Cornett given a lane down the middle of the field, and he is gone. 64 yards, 7-0 Marshwood. Gorham trying to answer with a pass deflected and ends up in the hands of John Valentine, who's going to get some positive yardage. Later in the quarter, Justin Bryant doing what he does. He's in scoring position when he walks on the field. 59-yard touchdown, 41-12, Marshwood moving on. Number 4, Biddeford hosting number 5, South Portland. Aiden Donovan caps a Tigers drive, and the Tigers go up 6-0 at home. Now, Tigers a chance to go up by more deep in South Portland territory, but Luca Desjardins, Connor Dobson combined for the stop. Red Riots get the ball back. Then Anthony Poole, who's been playing great down the stretch, to Tyler Small for the big game. From there, Poole takes it in. 41-19 South Portland. Red Riots have won 7 of 8. They have Marshwood next week. Massabesic, first home playoff game in forever, taking on Chevres. Stags up 22-21 in the third, thanks to a pair of Sean Tompkins TDs. Here, Josh Paquette rolling, finds Tompkins again, 30-21 Chevres. After the Stags force a punt, they keep riding the Tompkins train. Gets in open space, and nobody is going to catch him. See him, 75-yard touchdown, 36-20 Chevres. But Massabesic stages a huge comeback. After Orion St. Laurent TD, it's Nick LaBerge to Ricky Hendricks. Mustangs down 36-34 with 4 to play. Comes down to this, 3rd and 8 at midfield for Chevres. Who are they going to go to? And it's Tompkins sealing it with the first down carry. Chevres gets the win, 36-34, moving on, their first playoff win since 2016. Deering at Kennebunk, a disastrous start for Deering against Bunky and the Rams. Opening kickoff, Jacob Sullivan, scholarship player in lacrosse, but he can play some football too, to the outside, and then let's speed it up. That's a 70-yard touchdown return, 7-0 first play of the game. Deering's first play from scrimmage, Jack Andrews, the bobbling interception. A couple plays later, Tommy Lazos fakes the screen, oh, goes the other way for the screen, and hey, Sullivan, 2 touches, 2 touchdowns, quit while you're ahead, son, 14-0. After Deering fumbles its next snap, it's Ryan Connors, a 25-yard touchdown, 2:18 into the game, it was 21-0, 49-0, Kennebunk to win. They host Chevres next week. Northern B, 4th-seeded Windham, hosting 5th-seeded Skowhegan. Windham down in the 4th. Trying to get something going on 4th down. Harrison Boyle, the screen pass to Derek Palo, but he has stopped short of the 1st down. In the 4th, Windham tries the screen again. The Skowhegan defense comes up big. Skowhegan's defense was dominant tonight. They shut out Windham 27-0. They'll face Brunswick, who beat Brewer 47-0. 3rd-seeded Lawrence hosting 6th-seeded Falmouth Greeley. 4th quarter, Nate Rigaldo pounds it in. He's been a force this year. 34-8, Lawrence with the win. They are moving on. Unbeaten Coney and Mount Blue. What a game. Scoreless in the 2nd. Riley Geyer airs it out to Adrian Larrabee. This is a big play because Keegan Roberts strips him and Alex Davis recovers. No points for Coney. Ensuing drive, they swing it to Kevin Johnson. And no way you're going to arm tackle this big dude. Takes it in for the touchdown. And Mount Blue in overtime hands Coney its first loss, 21-20. The Cougars at Lawrence in the semis. What a game that'll be. Oh, in Class C, Cape and Freeport played a barn burner a few weeks ago. The same schools meeting tonight in the one that really mattered in Cape Elizabeth. Falcons, the Developmental League champions a year ago, lost to Cape earlier. They take a 14-7 lead in the 2nd quarter. Caden Benedict, the TD run. Later on, Matt Laughlin, what a year he's had, a touchdown run, and it's 14-13 at the half. Freeport on top as the conversion failed. Falcons capitalize in the 3rd quarter on special teams. On the punt, the Falcons block it. They get great field position. From there, Benedict again. This would go in, and he would help the Falcons. They score 29 seconds left to force overtime, and in double OT, Freeport stops a Cape 2-point conversion. 42-41, Freeport, a huge win. Top-seeded and unbeaten Levitt hosting Lake Region at Lewiston High School. 1st quarter, Wyatt Hathaway rolls, finds Cole Moore, and that's going to take it inside the 10-yard line. Next play, same combo. These guys are hard to stop. It's Morin from Hathaway, touchdown. 42-6, Levitt takes it. They'll host Freeport in the semis. 2nd-seeded York hosting 7th-seeded Poland. Poland, hey, they came to play. Late in the 1st, Brady Downing the touchdown pass to Isaac Fifield, and Poland, the seven seeds, down 14-8. But York, nobody as confident as these guys in the two-minute drill. Tegan Hines leading him downfield to Evan Burgoyne. Then Hines, the screen pass to Noah Carr-Mahalis, another first down. And that would set up a Riley Lynn touchdown. York eventually gets its offense going. They take it 49-16. Third-seeded Wells hosting six-seeded Freiburg Academy. First quarter, they get the ball to Peyton McKay, and that's a good thing. Going to the far side of the field, 15-yard touchdown run for the big man, 8-0 Wells. That Wells defense trying to make plays. Evan Leach stuffing the runner at the line. The Warrior fans are all pumped up for that. And then some bad luck for the Raiders. The snap over the head of the punter. Matt Ouellette with the room service touchdown. 34-14 Wells. They get a rematch with York next week. Eight-man playoffs. Miranda Cook hosting Ellsworth in the large school division. Opening Miranda Cook possession. Garrett Liberty. Quick pass to Joey DuPont, who makes a movie. Fumbles, but Isaac Philbrook is there for the recovery. That's what teammates are for. Few plays later, Liberty finds Philbrook for the touchdown. 44-12, Miranda Cook there unbeaten. They'll host the Mount Airy at Yarmouth winner next weekend. In the small school division, Old Orchard Beach hosting Trape Academy. Seagulls up big in the second. Trape trying to get something going, but Jaden Davies nearly picks it, or he does pick it off, and nearly takes it to the house before he's tackled just at the end of the half. Second half, Isaac LaChance opens the half with the touchdown run. 54-6 Old Orchard. They're moving on to face Booth Bay next week. All right, a week to go before the Class A playoffs start, but still playoff positioning and bragging rights on the line tonight is a regular season winding down. TA in Scarborough, a beauty tonight in Scarborough. Scarborough 14-13 in the third. Looking for more. Chase Cleary to Dom Spino. Touchdown, 21-13 Red Storm. TA puts a drive together in the early fourth. Costa Gikas, the TD run, and it's a two-point game. Then Gikas, the two-point conversion. It's 21-20. We're tied. Under 30 seconds left, still 21-21. Scarborough in the red zone, Cleary to the end zone for the win, but it's broken up, a game-saving swap by Colby Boldick. To overtime we go. Julian Bailey Cottle for Thornton, the touchdown. It's 28-21 TA. Red Storm answer, Cleary a TD run. 28-27, Lance Johnson and crew, they go for it. They want the two and the win, but TA stuffs it at the line. Second time this year TA has won by stopping a two-point conversion. They finish the regular season 9-0, their 20th straight win. Sanford shorthanded due to some key player suspensions on senior night, hosting Bonnie Eagle. The Spartans were fired up, though. Ethan Shane taking matters into his own hands. The sweep working, 53 yards, 7-6 Bonnie Eagle's lead at a point in the first. Later in the first, Spartans take the lead. It's Shane again with the juke, gets to the outside. Sanford up 12-7, looking for the big upset. But Bonnie Eagle's power running game on display tonight. Zach Maturo out of the Wildcat. Bonnie goes on for the 34-20 win. Up north, Bangor and Oxford Hills fighting for a home playoff game next week. Vikings go right to work. Ty LeBlanc takes the handoff on fourth down, goes 32 yards for the touchdown, 7-0 Oxford Hills. Next possession, Wyatt Knightley connects with Isaiah Ofiero for the score. Oxford Hills snaps a two-game losing streak, 34-7. Hey, Northern Sea MCI hosting Old Town. MCI takes the early lead when Ryan Friend finds Dominic Wilson, who's going to go down the sideline for the score. 34-6, MCI with the win. John Babst hosting Oceanside. Babst puts this away in the fourth quarter. Wilson Higgins connecting with Rhett McDonald in the end zone for 6. And Babs with a win 14-0. They're at MCI next week. All right, how about Holton hosting its first ever home playoff game against Foxcroft? But the Ponies played spoiler in the county. Austin Seavey and Lucas Ames hook up for the score. 46-14, Foxcroft takes it. Ponies at Bucksport next week. Thanks for watching Blitz 8. You can check it out again online at WMTW.com. We appreciate the viewing.